Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about how to write good scientific paper. Any students can follow, like engineering, science and technology, and medicine students can follow these things. When it comes to write a good scientific paper, tell a story in clear way. Use simple language and keep in mind the importance of the big picture, the pleasure of reading. Whether it is a piece of fiction, a poem, or a scientific paper, you know when you have read a really good one. We have all also struggled through really poorly written pieces with no end in sight. Though most of us have the luxury of abandoning pieces of writing that are not up to snuff, editors and reviewers do not and must slog through paper that seems to go on forever in an effort to kill two birds with one stone. We would like to give our authors a few simple pointers on how to write better papers and in so doing perhaps make everyone's lives just a little bit easier. Before we begin, our apologies to those for whom this is obvious. Our aim is not to be insulting. Instead, think of these are tips and gentle reminder of what you learned long ago but may have forgotten along the ways. First thing, tell a story. We all loved listening to a good story and we all tell stories. But some are better and it than others, and those who tell the best stories are most able to get their points across. How you got your data is not that important. We don't need a chronology. Instead, note that you have the data and have interpreted them a certain way. Think about how best to tell a story in light of all previous work in the field, the questions you are addressing, and why the question is important. How do your results advance our understanding of the questions? Have you discovered something new or unexpected? Consider how your findings fit into the broader context of the field, whether they are likely to change the way people in the field will think about the topic and how they will drive further experiments in the future. Second thing, be clear. Make your story clear is not the same thing as dumping it down. No reviewer has ever said that the paper was too easy to read. We do, however, get complaints from reviewer about how complicated or downright confusing a paper is. Clear, simple language allows the data and their interpretation to come through. Remember that clarity is especially important when you are trying to get complicated ideas across. Keep the jargon to a minimum and explain the terms you do use. When you are done, give your paper to a scientist outside your field and ask the person to read it for clarity. He or she will be able to point out all the remaining jargon, whether the experimental design, results, and data interpretation are clear, and how interesting your paper is to someone working in another area. Third thing, provide an informative title and abstract. Think, PubMed allows one to search through 19 million citations and table to contents e-alerts bring you the latest from your favorite journals. And what do you see when your e-alerts arrives or your search is complete? the title and the abstract. Most people will stop there without reading any further. So do not blow it with a boring title. Make the abstract clear and try to get the big picture across. Do not get bogged down in details. As an author, this is also your chance to draw your readers in, to entice them to read on. Title like studies of X and Y or characterization of A and B make my eyes glass over. They tell you nothing and do not offer much hope for the rest of the paper. The title should highlight the main point of the paper. The abstract should frame and the questions to be addressed and why they are important, how you have solved the problem, and how the results can be placed in the wider context of the field. The experimental detail should be left for the body of the paper, unless you are describing a new technique. End your abstract with the broader implications of the work. Fourth thing, make the introduction short and concise. Just remember, you are not writing an annual review of XYZ. You need to tell the reader only what he or she needs to know to understand this piece of work. We know that you know much more than you are telling us here. Provide just enough background so that the reader can understand how the questions you are asking fill a gap in the knowledge of the field. You should cite all the relevant references. Remember, we use PubMed too, and finish the introduction with a short paragraph stating what the paper shows. Final thing, clear distinguish results from discussion. The results should describe the results, and the discussion should put those results in a broader context. Thus, the discussion should not be a repeat of the result. Instead, it should be an interpretation of those results and how they fit or don't fit with previous work, as well as description of how your work provides a conceptual advance beyond those studies. The discussion should end with unanswered questions, a model in the form of a schematic diagram is often useful to tie together your work with previous data. I often find myself trying to draw one. I am sure the authors could do a better job. I did like to discuss the importance of the cover letter, but I am out of space, so I have to end right a few personal grips. Run a spell check before submitting your paper. Numerous spelling mistakes gives us and the reviewer the impression that the paper was either hastily or sloppily prepared, or both. Not a good start. Also, number your pages and figures, but please do not number the lines. It is very distracting. Once the paper is printed out and we being to read it, a lack of page numbers make our task and that of the reviewer most difficult that it needs to be. Use fonts and line spacing that are easy on the eyes. These are simple things that take only a few extra minutes when preparing our manuscript, but they can make a big difference to the experience of reading it. Remember, the idea is to make the editors and reviewers' life easier, not harder. Thank you for watching.